Reddit, what's your best funniest personal example of petty revenge? This happened a while back. Study hall in 8th grade actually. I always brought two small sandwiches to school so I could have one at lunch and one in study hall since our teacher let us eat in that class. One day as I was about to eat my sandwich, I get up to use the bathroom. As I walk back in the classroom, I see the kid in front of me eating my sandwich. I was pretty annoyed but nothing serious at this point, so I confront him politely and he denies it completely. I left my sandwich on my desk the next day just to make sure it was him. And what do you know? It is. So on the third day, I hatched a plan. I put habanero cheese on my sandwich, and then doused it all in ghost pepper sauce. That crap was everywhere, but it luckily didn't smell spicy. I get to study hall and my plan works flawlessly. I leave my trap sandwich on my desk and get up to use the restroom. This time I take as long as I can, and end up wandering the halls of the school. I did this because my study hall teacher was anal about the hall pass, and only one guy was allowed to leave the class at a time, even for water. After about 10 minutes I come back into the class to be greeted by the sandwich thief crying hysterically with a bright red face waiting for the hall pass. He was in the bathroom for the rest of the day. My ex cheated with a married man. He now lives with her. He is a pose. But anyway, I still have login for her DVR. I logged in, erased all her shows, then recorded only the show Cheaters. Petty, but it makes me laugh. A guy at work peed me off. I placed this Craigslist ad with his phone number. 2 free goats. Hablus Espinal. He spent the rest of the day getting calls every 15 minutes or so. My mom had a fantastic one. She was a language teacher at my high school and years after I had graduated, she called me kind of upset because a group of guys was trying to make her look dumb. The class was supposed to write one of those team dialogues in Spanish, and had a week or so to prepare it, then had to perform it in front of the class. When she called for them to do theirs, they said, "But we already did ours. We're not doing it again," she said. "You definitely didn't do it. I don't have any record of it here and I would remember it if you had." They refused to do it, insisting they already performed it and that it was her fault she didn't take notes scores down. She was feeling puzzled and questioning herself, when one of the good kids came and said, "They didn't do it. They were bragging about making you look stupid and threatened the whole class if they told you anything. But please don't tell them I told you this. I don't want any problems with them." These were those stereotypical dumb jock types who everyone was scared of for whatever reason. My mom was really into yoga at the time and got a great idea while meditating. She went in the next day and said, "Boys, I owe you an apology. I found my notes on your presentation and I do remember it. I don't know how I forgot." She went on to describe all the grammatical mistakes they made, that their dialogue hadn't been as long as required, that they didn't include the necessary vocabulary, etc. All made up. She failed them all on the project and they couldn't do a thing about it without admitting they'd made it all up. I was waiting for she told them it had been so good that they'd been selected to present it during a school assembly the next day, but this was better. Kid stole my water bottle. I opened it up and left it inside his backpack. When I was a kid I had a bedwetting problem. I am not ashamed of this now, as thousands of other kids have had the same problems. At the time however, this was humiliating. My younger brother started telling other kids around school how extensive the issue was. I was mortified. Even after our mother told him to knock it off, he continued. So I decided to level the playing field. The whole hand and cup of warm water deal didn't work. I stood over him as he slept one night and peed on him. The next morning, my mom was horrified and wound up taking a call from my grandmother. "I don't know what to do. Now both of them are peeing the bed," she explained, clearly frustrated. After a few more times of framing my brother as a bedwetter, he completely stopped using my embarrassing problem as entertainment. Had a chief warrant officer in Iraq throw a bottle of petroleum jelly at me after I got done ranting about something I've long since forgotten. Told me to go take care of it, and come back when I feel better. During his afternoon siesta I spent an hour covering everything on his desk with it in the most inconspicuous spots. For example, inside the handle of a coffee mug, underneath the handle of the Keurig pod loader, behind the canister holding Keurig coffee pods, anywhere he could grab something and not see it without first inspecting it. He came back and proceeded to curse at a rate never witnessed before, as he had to continuously wipe all the jelly off his hands every 3 minutes. He caught the jelly on the inside rims of his over-the-ear headphones before he rimmed his ears with it, but the best came after I let him calm down and get back to work. Everyone else in the office watched me do it. No one said a thing, but they all had their eyes on me as I waited 5 minutes before picking up my phone on my desk and slowly dialed the number at his desk. It rings. Everyone turns to look at him. He's on the computer, picks up the phone, slaps it to his ear. Radio Battalion Simosinofovich turns his head. Ear was caked full of petroleum jelly I had dumped all over the earpiece of the phone. Master Guns and Major told me these antics and pranks made that deployment. CWO Ryan, if you're reading this, sorry, not sorry. Speeding up a co-worker's double click speed and watch him squirm when his normal double clicking speed isn't working. Somebody once changed the mouse pointer on my chef's computer to the loading animation. We scratched our heads for a while before figuring it out. I have to admit, it was hilarious watching his mild irritation every day. In 7th grade, I used to take homemade lunch to school. We prepared our own salad dressing, lemon juice, salt, oil, etc. And one kid decided it would be good to steal it and drink it before lunchtime. I asked him not to, but he continued to drink it, but started doing so in one gulp, so I couldn't stop him. So instead of making a huge deal, I prepared two salad dressings, one that I would actually use on my salad, and another that had all the liquid condiments I could find in my mom's kitchen. It was really fun to see his face as he drank it. He never stole my salad dressing again. In Texas, there is a law that allows the US to take certain possessions to satisfy a debt owed, such as from a lawsuit. So this defendant had been committing Medicare fraud, got caught, has to pay back the money. He's also a total prick during the lawsuit, obstructionist, rude, etc. When the US finally has its judgment and he's pleading poverty, the US attorney that ran the suit basically ends up walking through the impoverished guy's multi-million dollar house to handpick what is going to be seized. He takes the big ticket items that he's allowed, but it's not going to be enough, so then he just starts taking little crap to pee the guy off. Book half read on the nightstand, gone. Can't take the garage, but you can take the garage door opener. So, gone. I don't know what else he took, but I think the idea is brilliant. The book would pee me off so much. My favorite childhood story. So I was an AP kid, and had a bunch of AP friends, and also was in sports and theater. I had a large bunch of friends in nearly every cliche. Anyway, one day, one of my friends gets sucker punched in the halls by some dickwad. Because of the school's zero tolerance policy, getting sucker punched carries the same punishment as sucker punching. So my friend and the dickwad both got in school suspension, but only one of them was punched on the face. I thought that was a little bit unfair, so I got my friends together, and they got their friends together, and every week, one of us would sucker punch dickwad. Every week, one of us would have ISS, and so would dickwad, but since we are many, none of us went to ISS twice. Dickwad on the other hand missed so much class that he had to retake the grade. I was casually walking my pup in the same area I usually do. It's a nice trail surrounding a wetlands reserve, and there's generally a lot of dog walkers and people riding bikes. The schools around here just let out for the day, and there was a group of three boys riding their bikes coming from behind me. I could hear their muffled talking and giggling, and all of a sudden they were a few feet behind me and one of them yelled, "Hey, catch," and threw some crumbled paper at me. I couldn't care less about the paper, but the yelling scared my lil pup, so I was naturally angry, but being awkward I didn't say anything. What am I going to do? Beat up some kids? I did have my pup's steamy tater tots in a bag, and as they rode off I lightly tossed it. By god, it lands in one of the kids' hoodies, and he didn't notice. They were too busy cackling away at how they got him. I saw them riding ahead, and it took maybe 100 yards before he noticed there were some little round brown dumplings in his hood. He screamed and threw the bag onto the ground while the other two died laughing. They looked back at me, but I was so far behind them that they just rode onward. I also couldn't help myself and laughed as I picked up the poo and threw it out a few minutes later. You know, got to be a good citizen and all that. Guys swerved across two lanes on the highway one day and cut me up. I slammed on the anchors and gave a good indignant blow of my horn. He starts acting like Mr. Angry at being called out, so starts slamming on his brakes, then speeding up if I try to overtake, flipping me the bird, the whole caboodle. Seeing the next junction coming up, I flash my lights and start beckoning to him in classic "you want a piece of me" mime, and mouthing "come on then," then start pointing at the upcoming junction. He obviously believes I actually want to go somewhere quiet and sorted out like men. I swerve angrily into the exit lane and he follows suit. Finally, I blow my horn and point at something on the junction, then, whilst he's distracted, swerve back out onto the main highway and speed up so I'm level with him so he can't get back over. He looks over in panic. I smile and blow him a kiss. The junction ends and he's stuck sailing off wherever the junction takes him. It's a 24-mile round trip to get back to here. Back in college, I was sitting in the library trying to work on an assignment. All was quiet for a while until this one obnoxious guy came in and sat at a table near me and proceeded to pull out his phone and have the loudest, most obnoxious conversation with one of his friends. Lots of "bro, seriously bro" and yada yada. I was about to pack up my things and find somewhere else to work when the conversation turned to Netflix. The guy told his friend he should just use his account, and proceeded to loudly state his email address and password for all to hear. This was too good of an opportunity for me to pass up, so I promptly logged in and navigated to the LGBT section and started adding the gayest movies I could find to the top of the queue. I like to think that both guys ended up thinking the other one added the movies to the queue but were too shocked to ever say anything to each other. Usually Netflix allows up to 3 screen streams at a time, so I would have been very tempted to keep 2 Netflix tabs open from his account on my PC at all times. Let them fight over the last connection. I once had a colleague I hated. He was very condescending and really arrogant. So I put an extra Bluetooth receiver in his computer for a computer mouse and kept the mouse in my drawer. I would just open my drawer and it would mess his crap right up. Kept it going for like 2 months. He was about to murder the world when I thought I better stop. Back when I was studying engineering, it occurred to me to try and find an app on my iPhone for those Panasonic projectors in lecture rooms. So I get the app and it just let me connect to the one in the class without a password or anything. I have a friend who is one of those perpetual pranksters. You can't leave your PC or bag or food drink unattended when he's around. So I beam a picture of him onto the projector. So the lecturer is just talking away and this goofy picture of my mate is on the screen. Lecturer doesn't realize yet. People in the lecture start waking up and giggling a bit. Now I use the pen function and draw dong on the picture too. Mate was red in the face and trying to hide. Lecturer finally noticed and says, "Michael, why is there a picture of you on the screen?" Finally, for a fleeting moment, I actually wrecked that sucker. This happened to my so when he was at university. Another comment here reminded me of it. His class were doing presentations in pairs, and he got paired with some girl who didn't bother to bring notes or research information for their presentation. She instead let him do all the work, and any slides she did were made from his notes and research. He complained to his tutor and she told him, "Don't worry, leave it to me." And then the day of the presentation comes. They present, and then at the end the tutor asks the girl a question. If I remember correctly, the question was something like, "Is there any evidence to suggest that some cultures are more prone to mental health problems?" And the girl answered no. The tutor then asked my sir the exact same question, and because he'd actually read the research on the topic, he was able to list off several studies that showed that some cultures are in fact more prone to mental health issues. The girl glared at him the entire time he answered the tutor's question. Pretty sure she ended up with a D, while he got an A or B. I had a 6-month school internship at a mobile phone store. The boss was a total butthole that treated his school interns like full paid workers, even gave me some concerning money responsibilities. A while after the internship, he called to tell me I would have to give a statement at court. He had a problem with some customer and a shipment and he planned to tell the court that he explained me everything concerning shippings precisely. Of course he didn't. And of course I didn't lie in front of the judge. My boss attorney gave me a look I will never forget when he realized his stupid plans didn't work out. A few weeks later, my now ex-boss tried to call me again. I didn't pick up. Frick this guy. On every email I send, I attach my name, company, position, etc. All the time people will respond, "Thank you, Sarah, but my name is spelled with the H." I have started to reply to them leaving off a letter of their name. No problem, Renee, have a good day, John. They probably think I am an idiot, but it is worth it to me. Keep up the good work, Hera. When I was a kid, I got the Sabrina the Teenage Witch handbook. It was full of kiddie experiences and stuff and was pretty fun. My older sister had upset or annoyed me about something, so I tried out one of the tricks from the book. You fill a cup with water and some corn kernels, put some tin foil on top of the cup. The kernels eventually pop and it makes noise against the tin foil. I put it under her bed. It takes a few days to work, so I completely forgot about it. Until one night I woke up to my two sisters whispering, it had popped in the middle of the night and she thought there was a rat under her bed. Someone in my office would always crush lunches with his gigantic ass lunchbox. Either he ate bricks or lead, I don't know. But I always came to the office fridge and found that my lunch was in pieces. So, after three bouts of this, and numerous notes from myself and other colleagues, I carefully removed his lunchbox, emptied the contents, a gigantic sandwich, a Twinkie, chips, some vegetable pieces, and a few other bits, and ran over them with my car. I carefully packed it back in, and put it back. He kept his lunch in a cooler by his cube from then on. Just saying that you went to your car and started it just to flatten the lunch is what makes this truly great. When I was a kid, my younger brother and I would go for extra Mandarin lessons after school. Then we'd take the bus back. He would never press the bell for the bus to stop because he knew I'd freak out and press the bell rather than miss the stop. So, one day when he was sitting on the bus but in front of me, I made sure to get off the stop before ours. I laughed my butt off when I saw the bus miss not just our stop but disappear into the distance. Petty? Sure. But I was about 12. We were sitting by a pool once, and a woman stood over my wife and started spraying sunscreen all over herself and my wife. We asked her nicely to please move and she ignored us and kept spraying. When we left, I took one of her flip-flops with me. As a nurse, we had this god-awful patient who made all our lives heck, needed pain meds on the dot, needed to smoke every half hour. Sat on the call light all dang day. This person was possibly the rudest human being I've ever met. Treated us like slaves, and was drug seeking. It finally came time for discharge, and this patient decided to come up with a whole bunch of new medical problems. I have chest pain. I have nausea. One side of my body feels numb so, being the very skilled and rational nurse I am, I asked the doctor for a whole new set of orders. First, I asked for lab draws every 3 hours, meaning needles every 3 hours, to check cardiac markers. Then I asked that the PT be placed on NPO status, nothing by mouth. For the nausea, this person couldn't go an hour without eating something. For the numbness, I requested the PT be placed on strict bed rest for 24 hours, and then have a physical therapy eval ordered, which meant no more going downstairs to smoke. I explained this all to the patient, and he says, "Crap, I just wanted to stay another night. I ain't doing any of that. I feel fine. Just give me my dang papers." Talked it over with the doctor on call. He gave me the all clear to discharge, and I had him out the door in an hour. Malicious compliance, the best kind. You have been visited by the Inspector Doggo. Comment your confession. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.